See those front feet, how they got little claws on them? See how they're little claws on those front feet? They grab stuff.
It's called the 4-H Science Blast. The purpose is to connect science and youth using a hands-on approach.
Hands-on is crucial. We want to get them in here and get them dirty, let them experience it. And not something that's abstract, but something local, something that they know is happening right here in their own lives, at home, and in their communities. So that's why we're going out to the river, taking a look at the water quality testing out here, experiments, and then giving them resources on how they can go home and measure their own carbon footprint to see the impact that they and their family have on the environment.
Kids measured the effects of carbon dioxide on water by using a straw to blow into a cup of water, changing the color from blue to yellow. But for scientists in the making, Johnathan, it was all about the bugs.
The bugs, they're like creepy crawly things. I saw a fish in there. It might have got curled up in a leaf too.
Everywhere you looked, Johnathan and his dad, Brad, were digging science.
I think kids naturally gravitate towards science. They're naturally interested in it. It's just that if there's nothing for them, that it doesn't fuel that interest. So I think so long as there's things like this around, that the interest will already be there. It's just a matter of fostering it and helping it grow.
The 4-H initiative, 1 million new scientists, 1 million new ideas, recognizes the need to enhance science education in our youth because there is science in everything.
It's really important because they'll be aware, they'll know what's out there, and they'll get experiences and they'll have fun with it. And if you have fun with it, you're going to love it. And that's a good thing, to have an interest and then can stick with it throughout their whole life. And there's many opportunities, there's so many things you can do with science.
Part of it is just helping to show kids that what they are doing is science, and they are scientists. We're just uncovering that potential.
Need to know precisely what to use in order to differentiate one bug from another? Just ask Johnathan.
I could look at it because I have a microscope, and I have like slides and extra ones to put it on. I have lots of things I can do with those bugs I can find.
From Michigan State University, I'm Craig M. reporting.